Hello subscriber and viewer, in this video we are going to learn how you can make the login app using relative layout. So we are going in the simple steps for making the login app. So here I already opened the Android studio. So first task is to drag and drop some component. So first I will add text view here. So this is the text view that I have added. Beside it, I want in text option plain text. Okay, so this is exactly plain text. I move this downside. Now it's okay. After that, in text option again I want text view. For adding password, this is the second one. Again I want plain text for entering password. After that I want button. Sorry here. So this is the second plain text. I want that button here. Okay, you can move upside. Now here just below the button I want one more text view component just below the button. I want big to show the message. So here I have done designing. I am going into coding now. Here I increase preview also for your observation. So I click here on the coding. So I am in first text box as you observe in the coding. So I don't change ID and all. I don't want text here, text view. So friend, whenever you give the text like that, you get the warning message. Okay, so for changing the text you can write string also. For example, you remove all text here, you select at the rate string, so the warning message will not come, and this is the proper way to give the string. Okay, so remaining code here, I want to say text size also Android text size. Okay, text size, in the previous tutorial we used DP, but it is better if you use SP value. I want 25 size and SP. Okay, so this variable name is A and I have to define its value in the string folder. How to open string? Go in app, resource, and here values. Here in the value, string.xml is there. So here previously I did this coding, I removed that. So upside you are getting this code, so you just copy that. Control C, Control V. Okay, now I am going in XML. What I have declared A, so I will in place of app name I will write only A, and here I will write username. Now we will go in the XML. You see username is coming. Okay, so I am going in designing part, little bit changing their position. So now it's okay. So username is coming properly. Now I want to move in second text box. This is here. I don't change ID because we don't need in the programming. So first I change text. Here you write string B. Okay. After that, I will go in XML. You just copy this code for saving the time. And here you write B. Here I want password. So this portion is done. Now I am going in XML again. You observe there password message is coming. Here we didn't set size, so I want particular size Android text size 25 SP. Now the password is coming. After that, I want to do the designing of password and username edit text. Okay, if you want, friend, you can give the background also, that we have already seen in previous tutorial how to give the background. If you want, you can do this. I will not do here. So I want to edit first edit text. So this is first. So I will write meaningful name E1. Okay. This is the first edit text, and here I don't want any text. In place of that, I want hint. Hint username. Sorry. So here it's E1 and its hint is username. I want to set text size also. SP. So now I'm going in second. This is E2. And here I don't want text. In place of that, I want hint. Hint is password. Text size also I want to set 25 SP. So we have completed to edit box button. Here in the button I want text login. So as I told you, by using string also you can give the value. Android text, here string is there. I want variable C that you declare in string.xml. Just copy the code. Here you change C, and here you write text name login. Now going back XML. Now I am going into last text view. Here I want meaningful name TV. After that, I don't want their text, so I remove this. I want to set size that I want 25 SP. So near about coding is over for the designing. I am going in designing. This is login. Username, password I just set their size 25 this is login, and here the message will come. Okay, so here we have completed designing part. I can move here little bit downside, so it's okay now. So here I have done designing part. Once again we will check. Properties of first edit is E1, second is E2, okay, and last one is TV, and button properties, all the IDs that you should know here. So here I am checking, this is button, so here button I want B, okay. So most of the coding is over here. Here you should set size. $25. Now it's perfect. Going back designing part. So it's looking good. You can do the changes by your own if you want. So here I am going into the main activity.java. okay, so here you should put up the code. So one thing is again required in the XML file that I miss out. Here I am clicking on button, and you have to add method Android on click and I want name login app. So your method name is login app. I am going in Java file, and here friend you should do declaration, edit text. I have to edit text, so first for login, so I should write login, or you can write simply lo, whatever it is, username we write, that is better for remaining. Username you should write meaningful, so no confusion will be there. Password. After that text view. Text view I have given ID TV. I want to show whether your user and passwords are correct or not, so it will show result. Then so these declarations we require, and we are initializing with their particular respective ID name. So you should write username equal to edit text. You have to do casting here, that you already know the procedure, I have taught you in previous tutorial. Find view by ID r.id. So edit text is there, so here we have the name E1, okay. Then password equals to edit text, find view by ID r.id.e2. That's it. Third one is result. Again you have to do same thing. Find view by ID r.id.tv. So we have done casting. Now we should do the coding for our login app, that is important. So here you should add method public void login app. So here this portion is important, and you have to write coding. So user will enter user ID and password, okay. So here I should write first string variable. Suppose I am writing A. So username value will be stored in username variable. So you should write that username dot get text dot to string. So friend, by this statement means whatever the values user will enter in text box, that value will be stored in username variable. So for reading this value, we need this statement because this value will be in string format. Okay, so that's why we are writing this code, and that value will be stored in A. Same coding we should repeat for second variable. Here I should write B, and here I should write password. So we have done declaration. Now I am going into condition. If here A dot equals, suppose I want username Suraj. Okay, here it's closing. And here B dot equals password I want same. Okay, so here the statement is A dot equals Suraj and B dot equal Suraj. And here I should write block of statement, means here I want result in text view component. So you should write result dot set text. I want to set message hello Suraj or welcome Suraj, whatever you want that you can write. After that, if the password not correct, then you have to specify the coding for else block. I copy the same, only the message I am changing. Sorry, try again. So this is the bunch of code that I enter. So I just revise this. Here we have done declaration, here we have done casting, and the main part is here, that method we declare in XML. So this coding is important. If the A dot equals Suraj means if the username value will be equal to Suraj and password value will be Suraj, then you get message hello Suraj, otherwise sorry try again. Okay, so it's very simple code. By using this statement, you will be able to read the value from edit text, and this value is assigning to A, this value will assign to B. Okay, so I hope you understood this coding. Now we will check output. Okay, so for that I have to start Jenny motion. So I minimize this. Here it's Jenny motion. So it will take the time to start. So here I am checking the output in the emulator. So finally we got output. So username I am typing correct one, here Suraj, and login. So our output is coming, but here one thing is missing in the coding. So here I am going in password. Here you should specify password so that it will be hidden, text password. Okay, Now once again we will check in emulator, click on OK, and once again we will verify the output. So here output came. So here you see the password is hidden, hello Suraj. And if you write different like anything, then sorry, try again. So in this way our program is perfectly working, and this is the simplest login app. If you want, you can give here color, background, whatever you want. Okay, I just taught you how you can make the simplest login app. You can give your color to background, that I already told in the previous tutorial. So here we finish this tutorial, and I hope you understood relative layout and how to make the login app. So don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.